Hey, Carter.
Carter Allen's Decibel Diaries on 100.7 WZLX.
It's the Decibel Diaries and WZLX. 2 hours of music stories and interviews from my vaults. I'm Carter Allen. And tonight, I'm talking Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers with Jon Scott, the legendary record company promotions man who resurrected Petty's first album from the cutout bin and turned it into an American breakout. Or was it breakdown? Jon Scott has written a book, and we're going to talk about it on the Decibel Diaries. Petty and the Heartbreakers' first song, first album, released November 1976. This is the Decibel Diaries. I'm Carter. That first Tom Petty album is a fantastic opening statement from what is now an iconic singer-songwriter and his band, who have sold over 80 million albums around the world. Tom Petty wrote dozens of worldwide hits, became famous as one of the finest songwriters of the era. While the group became famous for its tight and exciting rock and roll shows, rivaling Springsteen's E Street Band, and I think even the classic early 70s Who. But it almost didn't happen. Or maybe it would have happened in a totally different way. Jon Scott was a record label promotion man in Los Angeles when he began a new job at ABC Records in 1977. Completely by accident, Jon discovered Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers, a group that had its first album released and after 8 months discarded by the label. The group seemed likely to be dropped from ABC's roster. Jon Scott wrote a book about how he fell in love with Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers, turned ABC's miserable strategy of how not to break a band into a winning formula, and rescued that first album from obscurity. Tom Petty and Me is an exciting read. It's a must for Petty fans. And Jon Scott gave me a call to talk about it a couple of weeks back. I'm Carter Allen. I'm talking to Jon Scott, record company promotion man, legend in the industry. Hello, Jon.
Hey, Carter. How you doing?
Good, man. It's good to talk to you again. It's been an awful long time.
Oh, my gosh, it has.
Well, you've got this book out called Tom Petty and Me. And, you know, I mean, I thought to myself, oh, no, another book about Tom Petty. But, you know, you really have a unique story here because you were there at the very beginning for Tom.
Well, I wasn't there quite at the very beginning like you were. I was there 8 months after the record had came out. The record came out in November of 76.
Yep.
And I didn't go to work to ABC Records until August of 77.
That record was promoted by ABC Records, And after they got done with a certain amount of promotion, they just put it on a shelf and forgot about it. And I think this, it's one of the best stories in your book of how you started working for this record label in Los Angeles. You went into your new office and you actually found the Tom Petty record, but you didn't know it was Tom Petty. You want to explain that?
Yeah, it was really weird. I was going to lunch and I opened the closet door to get my jacket, and this album kind of fell down. And it had a white jacket, nothing on it. I think it said 10-76, and I assumed it meant October 76. And then I pulled the vinyl out, and that was completely blank. And I'm a music nut like you, and I hear Rocking Around With You, and I'm kind of bobbing my head. And then I hear a breakdown, and every hair on my body stood up at attention, goosebumps, the whole nine yards. And I know you know what that feels like.
Yeah. What's cool is that you have no idea who this is.
No idea. I mean, but when I heard Breakdown, my ears, I said, that's a hit record. I wonder who these guys are. And I said, well, I'll just keep listening a little bit more. And you know, it finishes up with American Girl. If that doesn't put chill bumps or goosebumps on you, nothing will.
Carter Allen's Decibel Diaries on 100.7 WZLX.
This is the Decibel Diaries at WZLX. I'm Carter, and I'm talking to Jon Scott, who first heard Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers' debut album in 1977 and had no idea who it was. He He writes about that discovery in his book, Tom Petty and Me.
After I heard American Girl for the second time, I was literally in a trance. So I ran to my boss's office. I say, who are these guys? And he takes the vinyl out and puts it on the turntable. About 10 seconds later, he goes, oh, that's that punk band, Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers. And I kind of go, what do you mean, punk band? He said, well, that's what radio stations are telling us. It's a punk band. It's only sold 12,000 copies, and it's dead in the water, and we're going to drop this band from the label. I'm like, what do you mean a punk band? This is one of the greatest rock and roll bands I've heard in years. And he said, John, come on, you're doing it now. You're getting involved. You're going to get yourself fired. I said, Charlie, I don't know the history of this record, but I think I can call some of my friends in radio and get them to listen to it again and get it played. He said, no. I said, wait a minute, Charlie, just let me try. Just give me 6 weeks. He finally said, and I got on my knees. I was that serious about this record. And, you know, at the time, well, he pulls the funny thing, the actual album cover out and goes, look at this guy. He's got bullets around his neck, black leather jacket, smirk on his face, long stringy blonde hair. He's a punk. And later I find out that album cover just some stations didn't even listen to the record. I mean, a lot of FM stations weren't playing punk bands back then. You know, they weren't playing the Ramones or the Sex Pistols or, you know, playing it pretty safe, you know, Jackson Brown and Crosby, Stills, and Nash. But it didn't really bother me. So finally, I got on my knees and he said, all right, I'll give you 6 weeks if you can get this unbankable punk record by Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers played. I'll kiss your ass on Sunset Strip. And I'll throw a party for you. Good luck. The clock is ticking. So I ran back into my office. I was excited, man. I didn't care what he said about a party. I didn't care. And I started calling some stations. They go, never heard of that guy. I sent 100 copies of the album out to 100 FM stations. And on the front of it, I said, just listen to the music. Forget the fucking cover.
Close your eyes and become a fly on the wall. We promise no swatting. It's Carter Allen's Decibel Diaries on 100.7 WZLX.
Sound.
It's the Decibel Diaries and ZLX and Strangered in the Night from the first Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers album. A record just packed with amazing rock and roll songs. I mean, that band had it figured out from the get-go. I'm Carter, talking to Jon Scott, record company promotion guy who worked at ABC Records in 1977, heard that album, and flipped out. He made breaking that album in America his mission in life, and he called on one of his radio buddies to help him do it.
By fate, a guy you know pretty well, I'm sure, Charlie Kendall, came to work at a station in Los Angeles called KWST, and he was going to be the music director. And I've known Charlie for years. I went to his house and said, Charlie, can I play you a record? I said, Charlie, this is one of the greatest records I've heard. And he said, oh, my God, John, I don't know how many times I've heard that before, but I'll listen. But he put the headphones on, and afterwards he had this glazed look on his eyes like, who the hell are these guys? He said, this is one of the greatest records I've heard in years. Are they any good live? And I went, Charlie, I have no idea. I just picked up this record by accident 3 days ago. I do know that they're playing at the Whiskey on Saturday night, opening for Blondie. And he said, we're going, right? I went, hell yeah, we're going. So we go to the Whiskey, and 7 o'clock, Tom was the first act. And we're both sitting there kind of going, please don't be a punk band. Please don't look like a punk band. They came out, and man, they all radiated their own coolness. You know, Tom had a scarf around his neck, and they had the Vox amps on the stage, and he had a flying V, and I'm going, all right. First song he rips off was Oh Carol by Chuck Berry, and man, he just kills it. And then they played Breakdown, and Charlie leaned over to me and said, I'm going to start playing this record Monday morning, once an hour, every hour. It's a hit record. And to me, I'm like, my heart is jumping, you know, holy crap, somebody hears what I hear. Thank God.
And that's how it started.
That's how it started, really. Yeah. Nobody in Los Angeles had ever played the record that I'm aware of. And that's when Charlie and I said, well, we got to go meet this guy. And so I walked in first. And I said, I looked around, and Tom's wiping sweat off his face. Hey, Tom, my name is Jon Scott. I'm the new head of album promotion at ABC. And he said, I don't give a shit who you are. And I said, he said, ABC's jacked us around for 8 months. Been advertising us in punk magazines, teen magazines. They don't know what the hell they're doing. And I said, well, have you ever heard your record on the radio in Los Angeles? And Tom Petty went, no, why? I said, well, you're going to hear it Monday morning, and you're going to hear it a lot, once an hour, every hour. He went, oh, my God. Here's another ABC nut job coming in here promising me something they can't deliver. You know that. I said, no, I'm serious. He said, just get out of here. Something made me just go, Tom Petty, I'm going to break your career wide open. Oh, my God. The expletives started flying. People laughing, all the band laughing. So at that point, you know, I've been listening to the record for weeks, and I knew what it sounded like. Now I saw them in person, and it just kicked in like, this is the real deal. Charlie and I started to leave. The roadie came over and started walking us out. And again, I turn around, and for some reason, I just go, Tom Petty, every time you hear your record on the radio, my name is Jon Scott. You're never going to forget me, okay? Ever. Don't forget it. And then, you know, Carter, this stuff is coming out of my mouth like, I didn't know if I could really do it, but I did.
And he became a good friend of yours because he did think of you every time he heard his record on the radio.
He did, man.
One man's musical journey through his past that just so happens to rock. It's Carter Allen's Decibel Diaries on 100.7 WZLX.
All right! alright if you love me. It's alright if you don't. I'm not afraid of you running away, honey. I get the feeling you owe. You see, there is no sense in pretending. Your eyes give you away. Something inside you is feeling like I do. You said all there is to say. Boston, give myself another girl, baby. It's all right.
Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers live at the Paradise Theater in Boston, July 15, 1978. Jon Scott has written an exciting book entitled Tom Petty and Me, with a foreword by John Mellencamp, no less. Jon Scott tells me more about his exciting journey with Petty next